What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to yet another episode of the Biz Bites and More podcast. I'm so happy to have you. This is your host, Grace, and I'm going to always be here for you, all right? Not like your father that walked out on you, you know, 20 years ago saying he's going to get cigarettes. Dad, I didn't forget, all right? And I'm so excited to be here with you guys today. This is a very special episode of the Biz Bites and More podcast because this is a lunch hour series like I was talking about the other two fucking times or whatnot. All right, guys. So welcome back to yet another. And the lunch hour series, as we discussed, is a little interview segment. All right. Today, I have a very special guest with me. His name's Spencer. Spencer, how you doing today?
Hi.
Who are you?
Who am I?
Yeah.
I'm your roommate.
Oh, wow. Well, that was... That's exactly who you are. Okay.
That's all
and,
I am.
You're a little more than
you.
That.
Yep.
Well, Spencer, today we're going to do about 20-30 minute episode. We're going to go over questions. We're going to talk about you. We're going to talk about life. We're going to talk
about
different things that tickle your fancy, that get you hard in the morning. Okay.
Okay.
And it's not good health, even though that is a sign of good health. As we know, with all lunch hours, that when you're on your lunch break, you drink. So during lunch hour podcast, it only feels like an obligation, if you will, to drink. So as we did with our last episode, Spencer, welcome to your first shot of three. Let's go ahead and take this down.
Thank you.
And get to the questions. Good. Got away. All right, well, I'm a little scared for how the other two are going to go based on that one. Sweating a little bit. All right, Spencer, welcome to the show, of course. You already kind of told us about yourself. Well, where are you from, Spencer?
I'm from West Virginia.
Okay, that's a big state.
Can this hear me?
Yes, that's a big state.
It's small.
Well, where in West Virginia?
Yes, that thing can hear you.
Okay.
Yeah, just talking to
you. Okay.
Where?
Lewisburg, West Virginia.
Wow.
Frankfurt, West Virginia.
Known for
the Mountaineers.
The Greenbrier. Okay. All right. What do you do for work, Spencer? What do you do?
I work in logistics.
Oh God.
Yeah. Not much to talk about there.
Yeah. Is it a lot of dildos?
We ship dildos, yes, occasionally.
What do you dream about, Spencer?
What do I dream about?
Yeah.
Nothing. I don't dream.
Holy fuck.
I really don't dream.
All right. I was expecting a little more with that one, but all right. Next up, looking at my notes. What are your ambitions, Spencer? Where do you want to be in life? Huh?
I want to be a hillbilly.
Hillbilly. All right.
Like poor. Like, you know, like.
Hey, you know, whatever floats your boat or drives your van or you know, writes your cardboard sign. Okay, Spencer, do you have a history? This is one of the more important questions.
Okay.
Do you have a history with acid reflux?
No, but I gag a lot, uncontrollably. Like I gag all the time.
Okay. All right. Those were the easy questions, Spencer. Now I'm going to get into the hard ones. First up, marry, fuck, kill, Jesus, Princess Diana, Gandhi.
What?
Marry, fuck, kill. Princess Diana, Jesus, or Gandhi?
Are you asking me a question or are you just
okay,
saying...
so I'm gonna kill Jesus, okay? Because you know what? He's at a crucifixion. What more could we do to him that would make him feel any worse? I will fuck Gandhi. I'm going to clap those little Indian cheeks. And then I'm going to marry Princess Diana for the wealth. What about you? It's right there if you want to. Marry, fuck, kill, Princess.
I don't get the marry, fuck, kill part.
Who would you like to marry?
Oh, okay.
Fuck?
Got it.
And who would you kill?
Got it.
All right. So who would you fuck? Jesus, Princess Diana, or Gandhi?
Well, Princess Diana.
All right. Who would you kill? Gandhi or Jesus?
Gandhi.
That was quicker than most. And then you're going to marry Jesus. Well, that's, hey, that would kind of be a turnaround for Jesus.
I know.
Because he'd be like, oh,
shit.
Just
break the world. Yeah.
That was a really good answer. Wow.
Yeah, the world
would That was way better world, than I was thinking.
The world oh, would man. Explode if we yeah. married Jesus.
Oh, wow. Think of all the hillbillies out in West Virginia mm-hmm. that are, you know, yeah, all the, homosexual actually, mm-hmm. but they're so homophobic that yeah, they've never, you know, they kissed Dave last night and they were just drunk, so they remember it. All right, Spencer, next. That was a really, that was actually really, I'm actually super impressed by that. That was good. All right, next up, Spencer, Burger King.
Ooh, the BK Lounge, thoughts. First off. The BK Lounge.
Go into it. What is that? Where are we?
Where are we? What do you mean? I love the BK Lounge. What about it?
Tell us about it.
They have croissants. Listen. They have croissant-widges. And they have hash browns that are circular, and they also provide cheesy tots to their morning customers as well.
That was it? That's, you'll never be an ambassador for Burger King. Okay. All right. Next question up, Spencer. That was, I don't know where this, I was expecting a lot more from you. You love Burger King. Okay.
I do.
Flint, Michigan gets clean water, or you get the car of your dreams. Follow-up question, what color is the car?
Flint water gets clean water. Flint gets clean water.
So you're going against the dream car.
Yeah.
Well, we had a prize for you at the end. Never mind.
I feel like that should be a question for Donald Trump, not me. isn't that in the Clean Water Act? Is that every American's provided clean water and safe drinking water?
I thought that was for Native Americans.
No, that's for every American. That's like our right.
Well, you learn something every day, guys. What's that again? The Clean Water Act?
Clean Water Act.
When was that passed?
I forget when it was passed, but it's valid.
Well, fuck me in the asshole and call me fucking Chase, because there's yep. a Clean Water Act out
there. We're all entitled to clean water. As a matter of fact, every single one of us.
And love.
And if we don't have it, then...
Do you think we should be in...
That's the government breaking the law.
Oh, I was about to ask a great question. Okay.
Take a shot.
Great. Well, spank me on the vagina and call me Eleanor Roosevelt, because yes, we can take a shot. All right, second shot for the podcast. This is actually going swimmingly, a lot better than I was expecting, so that's great.
My hands are sweaty.
Don't touch me. Okay. All right. Felt like Bill Cosby, but from the victim's stand. Oh, Grayson. That was not. Okay. All right. Here we go. Second shot of the interview. As always, we will be doing three. Second one. Let's go. Down the hatch. Oh, well, my vagina is quivering like the last one. I was just spat that up. But the interview goes on. So, Spencer, what you said there actually made it helps with my next question. And that is, this isn't my next question, but a question: should the internet be a public utility? Just like everyone.
What do you mean by a public
utility? Like just everyone that is like free water acts. Like should everyone be entitled to internet, interwebs? Should everyone be able to get on Pornhub and tug one out in the public library? Well, that was some kids are going to use it for school, but I would imagine that some homeless people are going to.
At this point, no. We can't supply people with internet. No.
Why?
Because it's a hot commodity and it costs money. And maybe when Elon Musk gets his satellite up in the air and
looking at my questions.
And we can get that going.
Elon.
Yeah.
Musket. Okay. The Muskets are gonna save us. Okay. All right. So this follow up question, is the internet a distraction?
Is the internet a distraction? No. Are our phones distractions? Yes.
Why is that?
Well, because they're just accessible.
Do you ever put it up your flesh pocket? Hide it away for a little while?
Flesh pocket. Asshole. Fleshlight?
Asshole.
Asshole?
Flesh pocket.
My flesh pocket.
Your flesh
pocket. Not my fleshlight. I thought you were asking about my fleshlight.
Do you have a fleshlight?
No.
Do you have a fleshlight?
Yes.
Oh, God. Yes. See, this is why
why not? Well, this is why with that?
Well, this is why you wouldn't be able to tell Frank about the fucking podcast, you dipshit, because he'd be saying shit like,
what's wrong with having a fleshlight?
I never said anything.
Bring that into this podcast.
Bring that into this
podcast. First of all, what's wrong with having a fleshlight?
Look, Grayson gets it all done with Rosie Palmer, all right? If you have a fleshlight, that's fine. But if there was a masturbatory Olympics, that would be like doping or the things. Well,
why don't you get you a fleshlight? We'll reach you out to Fleshlight after this
fleshlight.com.
after this podcast, and we'll see if they'd like to be a part.
I would love for Fleshlight to be a sponsor or anybody. Okay, Spencer, we're digressing. All right, Spencer, what if God were really one of us? And would he be Klup?
Similar. Jurgen Klopp is the closest thing to God that exists on this planet Earth.
Spencer says God is white. He's white.
Have you guys ever seen a picture of God? He's definitely white.
Well, I think God is, to me, God is a homeless man yelling at a cracked TV in a McDonald's parking lot. That's who God is to me. Okay. I appreciate that answer, though. Next up, Spencer, is pigeon versus chicken, and I want you to think about this.
Okay.
You got your country bumpkin, which is a chicken, and your street thugged out pigeon.
Okay.
Who's going to win? Would you ever eat a pigeon burger?
No.
Me neither. Okay. Who would win?
A chicken.
Why?
Because they got fucking talons.
Okay.
And I mean talons.
Okay. Well.
And the roosters are badass dudes.
That's true. There's cockfighting. There's not pigeon fighting.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe that's something that we should start pushing more. Maybe to stop cockfighting, pigeon fighting should be more mainstream.
A little bit more of a safer alternative.
Street rats.
Not as violent, is what you're saying. More like boxing compared to MMA.
I feel you, brother. Not physically. No, I do. But I feel you. All right. What is more scary, Spencer, losing your job or clowns touching you? What do you fear?
Losing my job every day of the week. I go to bed thinking about that every night almost.
See, I always think of clowns touching me.
Yeah, I'm thinking about my job.
But that was because of my Boy Scout leader. Okay. We have two more questions left. Where were you when Paul Walker died?
When Paul Walker died, I was in Charleston, South Carolina, sitting on the couch with Ryan watching TV.
Suspicious. I wrote that down. Suspicious. I write that about every interview.
Why is that irrelevant?
Okay, and finally, Spencer, to end off the interview, what have you thought of it so far? Did you like it?
It's been great. It's been a great time. It's been
brown noser. Brown noser. Okay. All right. Last but not least, Spencer, are aliens real?
Well, yeah.
Would you clap alien cheeks?
I would.
Avatar situation. Well, no. Not an avatar situation. You are a human and you're going to bang an alien.
Yes.
You'd bang an alien?
Absolutely.
I'd bang an alien too. What if sex robots came out? Would you bang sex robots?
Yes.
I would bang sex robots.
But I can't. You would have to buy one. Well, you're at that point where it's buy or not, then it's like, okay, we have to measure how much.
I think we already got an answer from you because you have a fleshlight. So
fleshlights are $60. $60, fleshlight.com. Order yours today. I think they include free shipping and they include lubricant. Everything else you would need for your, you know, the whole ordeal.
So guys, Spencer, are there any questions you have for me? Anything that you would like to talk about before we end this off with our third shot? And then our post shot.
Oh man. Yeah.
Go ahead. What is it, Spencer? Speak to the world. Hey, we talked a lot about pigeons today. I didn't even plan for that.
Yes, we did. Nice.
What's that brand? Go ahead and plug them really quick.
They don't have one. Travis gave me this sweatshirt.
It's called deadpigeon.com. Order your dead pigeon today.
That's false. It's not true.
Yeah, get yours free.
That's not true.
Spencer, anything you'd like to plug? Anything you'd like to say about our world, the economy, the GDP of local small towns, cunts across America, or CAA as we like to call it. Anything?
Not really.
Well, great, Spencer. It has been a fantastic time talking to you.
You as well.
We are about at 19 minutes, about 20.
That's pretty good.
Coming up. Third shot. Let's take it down. And what else has happened in your week? What's happened in your life? Anything?
I had two coworkers calling sick today.
Yeah.
They
sound like cunts. That's okay.
Yeah.
One of them definitely is. All right. Well, guys, drink your water. Be safe. Go to the Biz Bites. And that – well, sorry. I was doing my outro. Spencer, anything else?
Not really.
Wow. He had
– I want another interview.
He said have the chance to, you know, donate to, you know, the causes that you believe
in. No, go to fleshlight.com. Free shipping on orders over $55.
Guys, that is the Biz Bites and More podcast. This was your volume 2 of the Lunch Hour series, and I'm going to have many more. I have Carl down for 5. Spencer, do I have you down for 5?
5 interviews?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. We got 10. We at least have 10.
I'm gonna request some open-ended questions where, you know, we can elaborate.
Pigeon versus chicken.
Not pigeon, but that's a one-answer question. That doesn't mean open-ended. That means
you could have gone into
what's Akon City?
What's Akon City? Oh, actually, wait, you read off my notes, you piece of shit. God, fuck, you cunt. All right, guys, that is the episode. We have Spencer on for 5, Carl on for 5. I'm going to call a buddy in North Carolina. I have another buddy here from West Virginia again. It seems like I only have a bunch of West Virginias. All right, go to the Biz Bites and More blog.com if you'd like to. Check out blog material. Twitter at Biz Bites and More. Follow the podcast. You can leave a voice message if you'd like. anchor.fm/biz-bites-in-more. All right, just fucking do it. All right, leave a voicemail. I will read it. I will listen to it verbatim on the show, and I will respond to it. All right, you cunts, have a good one. I love you all. Until next time, that's my take on it. I'll see you later. Bye now.
Ciao, salamis.